Hello, today I'm here with a new video and today I'm here with a new first impression. It feels like it has been a while since I did a first impression, and today we are going to test out a new brand and we are going to test out Certifeye. It's a new brand for me, the Tropical Wonders palette, and I really really love this palette. It looks like this. So this is a all matte rainbow palette. I also bought the Dynasty palette at Black Friday sale, and this has also shimmers, but it will come a first impression on this one. But I think I wanted to start with the Tropical Wonders. So first of all, the palette is beautiful and it's cardboard. I love it, and I love the artwork. It's a lion here and an elephant here. I immediately want to use like these three colors because I always use orange, yellow and red. But I think I have to do something else as well. So I'm going to do two different eyes. So one eye is going to be these three colors, and the other eye, I'm not sure if I'm maybe going to take these three, or maybe this, this and that, or maybe that one. I don't know if I want to do a green and a blue or a green, purple and blue. I don't know. So we just get started with the eye that I want. I know what I want to do with. So I'm going to use eyeshadow primer. I will start with the red one, Red C, and I will do two colors in my crease. So yeah, we'll take this Red C, and I have heard that these have a lot of kick up. There's no worries, and I take this on my outer crease. Oh god damn. This was pigmented and I just panic cleaned my brushes, so this is a little bit fluffier than it usually are. And oh my god, what a red shade. Now I have taken it too far in. I hope I can save it. So this was like super pigmented and super easy to blend, and I think I'm done like this. I took a lot. It was more pigmented than I thought it was going to be. And then I will take Toucan. And I take a smaller and pointier blending brush and put this in my inner crease. What is it called? Is it called the inner crease? In the corner, but the inner corner is not there, so I don't know. And this is also really pigmented, and I think it's true to color. It's not like this super bright orange in the pan and not on the eyes either, so that is good. And I think I will take the red one also out here. And then I will take the orange again and put it maybe two here, and then I take the yellow one. Okay, this is a really, really nice orange. I like love all the oranges. Even if it's bright orange or if it's a little muddier orange, I like them all. I feel like I have too much red in my crease, but I think when I have the eyebrows and everything, I hope it will be better. So I will take Sunray and put it there in. And I really, I'm wishing this yellow to be super bright. It is pretty bright. It's not, I think it feels more yellow in the pan than on the eye, but it's it's showing on the eye as well, so I'm okay with that. I take it in here as well. I think I want a little bit more of the orange in here to intensify it a little bit. So I think I'm satisfied with the lid like this on that eye. And then I have to decide what to do on the other eye. Do I want purple? I don't think I do. I think I'll take this Atlantic, this blue one, and this Swamp and Fruit Dove. I hope that can be cool. And I want to do like the same thing as I did on the other eye, but with other colors, of course. So I will take Atlantic, the blue one, as the red one. And maybe I'm going to be a little bit more easy this time. Okay, this was not as bright that I expected it. I expected it to be more blue. It is blue, but okay, I'm going crazy with my hair right now. I thought it was going to be a little bit more, I don't know if I want to say brighter blue, more like true blue. If you look at my eye and the color here in the pan, it's not the same. But I maybe just have to build it up a little bit. So this was not like the red one. It was not bam in your face right away. I mean, it's a good thing sometimes, but yeah. Okay, when I build it up, it becomes a little bit more true blue. I think it needs like the darkness of the blue, if that makes any sense, to be like the pan. Okay, so now I'm going to take Swamp, as I have the orange one. So I'm taking a small blending brush and put it in a crease, and I hope that these will go together. And yes, they do. So this is like the colors I love the most on that eye and on this eye. It's colors that I am okay with. So this was the Swamp, and now I will take Fruit Dove. No, I don't want to do this. I'm going to take Atlantic and put it a little bit here, so I close it here. Maybe I need another brush. So I just want to close it here, and with this brush it was more opaque at once, so maybe it was not just a good shade to have in your crease. I don't know. And is it a little bit patchy? So I take this brush instead. This is a brush from H&M. Fill in the gaps. And this brush worked so much better than my blending brush for this blue one. Okay, so now I will take the Swamp and put it here. You know the drill. And this was a really nice green color. I think I like the lime greens the most, or the greens like this that are like green. Just super green. Doesn't feel like the blending up here is super good. Okay, I don't know about this eye. Maybe this was a bad idea. So now I am not sure if I want to take this Fruit Dove or this Bermuda. Let's swatch them. I think I'm going with Fruit Dove, not Bermuda. Okay, this was maybe too like to the swamp color, because it doesn't feel that you can see any difference between them. It feels like they look the same on the eye, and I don't like that, because I wanted that like pop of color that I have. But maybe it is because this is so light. They are too alike on the eyelid, which is for me a little bit strange, because you see here, the swatches, they are not alike. But on the eyelid, they seem... It seems like I have one green. But I think we have to live with it. I am going to fix my base, and then we're going to do the under eyes. But so far, I like this eye the most and not this eye. So I will take away the fallout, because I have some fallout, but I have packed so much shadow on. So I will take away the fallout, fix my base, and then I will come back and we fix the under eyes. So the base is on, and now I'm going to do the under eyes. And I have decided to use two colors. First, I thought I was going to do the same, like here on this eye and that on this eye. But I want to change it up. So I'm going to take the orange under this eye and the green under this eye. And I have no idea how this is going to look. Maybe super crazy, but I think it's more fun to do that than do the same thing as I have here. So I am a little bit afraid now, so I will start with the green one under this eye. And I will only take swamp, the dark green here, like the only green you can see. So we will see how this goes. And I am sorry, but I can't film while I do this, because I look like this. So I just come back when I have done it and you will see how it looks. So the under eyes are done, and I'm going to take crayons from Linda Hallberg again in my waterline. So I'm going to take the likable mood in this and calm mood, so the green and orange, so it's look a little bit better. I changed my mind and took the yellow one instead, the happy mood, because this orange, it turned out like yellow underneath my eye, and I don't understand why. So this is the look without mascara. So I'm going to put on the mascara, and I am going to spray my face with some setting spray, because I feel pretty dry now. Put on a lipstick, and then I will be back and tell you my final thoughts, or my first thoughts in this first impression. So this is the finished look. For lips, I took Kiss from Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is one of my absolute favorite lipsticks. And this is the look. So this is my first impression of the Tropical Wonders by Certifeye. So I have used these three colors, and Swamp, Fruit Dove, and Atlantic. And my first thought is, these three colors, so freaking good. This Fruit Dove and Swamp, on the eye, they almost look the same. I don't know if it is that they are next to each other. It looks like that. And also this Atlantic was a little bit, I don't know if it's dry. It doesn't feel dry, but it's a little bit patchy. So you have to build it up. Now I have blue everywhere. So you have to build it up. Like this red one, this is one of the best reds that I've ever tried. But this Atlantic, you have to build it up, because if you just swoop it, it doesn't come to anything. So this is build up, and I had to take a more dense brush like this one to pack it on, and also take it in my crease. You can work with it, it's not a bad shade, but you maybe can't work with it like you normally do. And my cat is lying there, showing her little fluffy belly, and look so freaking cute. But these three colors, can't complain on that one. This one, I don't know, because it looks just like this on my eyes. The only thing I have to say about this orange is, here you see it's super orange, but under here it looks yellow. And I don't know if it's because under here I took it on, I didn't have a sticky base. I took it where I already set my concealer, so it could be that. So it turned out yellow instead. I'm okay with it because here it is orange. And I think these three was really true to pan. This was also true to pan. This was not super true to pan. It's okay. I think it's more true to pan now. I have to check the viewfinder. It's a little bit more deeper here, but I think you can build it up. And one thing I can see already now, this is going to be so dirty. I don't know if you can see it, but like, it's red out here, it's orange here, it's green here. And I usually don't clean my palettes because I don't really care, but now it's black everywhere. I think I have to do it with this because I think this is going to get so dirty. But I really like the format of the palette, and it's going to be so fun to try more of these. It's going to be fun to try this one and also that pink one. But for the first impression, it's a good palette. Some of the colors you have to work more with, and some are super easy. So this is my first look with the Tropical Wonders, and I think I'm going to do a 3 looks 1 palette with this one because it feels like I'm going to do that with all of my palettes this year. So I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos. And I will see you in the next one. Bye!